Good day, everyone. GarageKing here, and today I'm going to show you how to check an oxygen sensor. This one has four leads. That means that it's heated. Some of them have three leads. Some of the older ones have two leads, and some of the very, very old ones only have one lead where they actually use the sensor body itself as a ground. So if we think to ourselves, this one's got four leads. Two leads are used for the heater, and two leads are used for the oxygen sensor itself to produce the voltage. So if we connect an ohm meter to the two leads, which are usually the white leads, then we should have a resistance, and that'll tell us if our heating element is good. So first we're going to check the heating element for resistance. So normally it's a two white wires. If it's not the two white wires on yours, you can just keep trying different combinations until you get it. You're not going to damage anything by doing that. So two white wires, let's plug our little connectors on like so, and then we're going to hook them up to our multimeter over here. So let's hook it up to our multimeter. Put on ohms and let's see what we got here. Ohms, that would be this one. Maybe I need a new battery soon. And there's our ohms. So 10.9 ohms, that is okay. We should get around the 10 ohm mark. So we know the heating element is okay. So let's turn it to voltage. And let's hook up the other two and let's apply some heat and see what happens. Here we go. So now we've applied, or we've hooked up the black and the gray one. And now we're on the millivolt, we're on the volt scale. And let's see what type of voltage we get out of the O2 sensor when we heat it. Now I'm just, for this test, I'm just using a butane torch. It might take a bit to get this thing heated up, but once it heats up, we should see some volts coming out there. And all oxygen sensors produce between 0 and 1 volt. So we should get somewhere around there. Let's check it out. And what it actually does is it measures the amount of oxygen that's left, which depending on, like with this flame, there's not much oxygen left because the flame's burning it all. And you can see it's going up. It's still on the millivolt scale. Let's get a little more heat maybe to the back side here. And there we go, we're at 0.3 of a volt, 0.2 of a volt. We're back to the millivolt scale, 0.4 of a volt. And there you go. So we're roughly around half a volt. So we know this thing works, 0.5 volt, 0.6 volt. So it's working. So why did I change this? Well, it did have a check engine light and the computer kept saying this is faulty. Now there's a number of things that can happen. We know here it's working, but what we don't know if it's calibrated right. And if it's not calibrated right, that's why you can get a check engine light. So a lot of times they don't heat up fast enough, maybe because they're dirty. So then you'll throw a check engine light if it doesn't heat up fast enough. The other thing is, if it is dirty there, it may not be reading the proper amount that the ECM is calibrated for. So there could be a number of things. So we know this one actually works. It did have a check engine light, so I did replace it, but it's probably not calibrated, right? Because it's probably all dirty. Now, what I could do is I could try to put it in some gasoline or some type of solvent, clean it, put it back in the vehicle and see if it works. But in this case, it was just faster just to replace it and the check engine light never came back on. So I can conclude that this does work, but it's out of spec. So if ever you pull your oxygen sensor, this is an easy way to test it. But if your check engine light's on, I would have to guess that it's probably just dirty and you gotta clean it. Now, I don't know if it's worth your time to clean it or not. You can see what you wanna do. If you wanna clean it, try it. Maybe that's what I should do on one of these other check engine lights that I get on. If it's an oxygen sensor, maybe I should take it out, do this, clean it, put it back in and see if it actually works. So with this one, I actually just replaced it. So now we're just checking the old one. So we know it does function the way it's supposed to function, but it's probably just out of calibration because it's dirty. So anyway, that's it for my video today. Nice and quick, folks. Hopefully you've enjoyed my video. I'd appreciate if you would subscribe. It means a lot to me trying to grow my channel. That's it, GarageKing over and out. I'll see you on the next one.